Hello friends, welcome to Brain Scoop channel. This is my first video on this channel and our today's topic is ultrasonic transducers. An ultrasonic transducer is a device that can convert one form of energy into another. Ultrasonic transducers are used to convert an electric signal into an ultrasonic energy. They can be transmitted into tissues and to convert the ultrasonic energy reflected back from the tissues into an electric signal. Ultrasound is produced and detected with a transducer composed of one or more ceramic elements with electromechanical properties. The ceramic element converts electrical energy into mechanical energy to produce ultrasound and mechanical energy into electrical energy for ultrasound detection. Here is an image. The general composition of ultrasonic transducer is shown in this figure. The most important component is a thin piezoelectric crystal element located near the face of the transducer, which is approximately 0.5 mm. Next, the front and back faces of the crystal are coated with thin conducting film to ensure good contact with the two electrodes that will supply electric field used to strain the crystal. The surfaces of the crystal are coated with gold and silver electrodes. The outside electrode is grounded to protect the patient from electric shock, and its outside surface is coated with a watertight electrical insulator. The inside electrode abrupts against a thick packing block, as you can see here, that absorbs sound waves transmitted back into the transducer. The housing is usually a strong plastic, an acoustic insulator of rubber or cork is present too that prevents the sound from passing into the housing. Over the past several decades, the transducer assembly has evolved considerably in design, function, and capability. From a single element resonant crystal to a broadband transducer array of hundreds of individual elements, a simple single element plain piston source transducer has major components including the following: the piezoelectric material, matching layer, backing block, acoustic absorber, insulating cover, sensor electrodes, and transducer housing. Now, what are piezoelectric materials? A piezoelectric material, often a crystal or ceramic, is a functional component of the transducer. It converts electrical energy into mechanical energy by physical deformation of the crystal structure. Conversely, mechanical pressure applied to its surface creates electrical energy. Piezoelectric materials are characterized by a well-defined molecular arrangement of electrical dipoles. An electric dipole is a molecular entity containing positive and negative electrical charges that has no net charge. When mechanically compressed by an externally applied pressure, the alignment of dipoles is disturbed from the equilibrium position to cause an imbalance of the charge distribution. The potential difference is created across the element, with one surface maintaining the net positive charge and the other surface a net negative charge. Surface electrodes measure the voltage, which is proportional to the incident mechanical pressure amplitude. Conversely, application of an external voltage through conductors attached to the surface electrodes induces the mechanical expansion and contraction of the transducer element. There are natural and synthetic piezoelectric materials. An example of natural piezoelectric material is quartz, commonly used in watches and other timepieces to provide mechanical vibration source at 32.768 kHz for interval timing. This is one of the several oscillation frequencies of quartz determined by the crystal cut and matching layers. For PZT in its natural state, no piezoelectric properties are inhibited. However, heating the material past its Curie temperature and applying an external voltage causes the dipole to align in a ceramic. The external voltage is maintained until the material has cooled below the Curie temperature. Once the material has cooled, the dipole retains their alignment. At equilibrium, there is no net charge on ceramic surfaces. When compressed, an imbalance of charge produces a voltage between the surfaces. Similarly, when a voltage is applied between electrodes attached to both surfaces, mechanical deformation occurs. piezoelectric element is composed of anion molecular dipoles. Under the influence of mechanical pressure from an adjacent medium, the element thickness contracts, achieves equilibrium, expands. This causes realignment of electrical dipoles to produce positive and negative surface charges. Here is the example. When one is of compression, when no voltage is applied, it is at equilibrium, and the third one is at expansion. So this is compression, equilibrium, and expansion. The external voltage source applied to the element surface causes compression and expansion from equilibrium by realignment of dipoles in response to the electrical attraction or repulsion force. So if you like this video, please like and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for the further updates. Thank you.